Thank you. are always glad to see my face. I wish that I could spread my net for every bridge I'm left. I hate them all, they do not go free till all the girls belong to me.
And not boast about your heroic deeds that others have accomplished.
Yes! Did you vanquish that serpent?
Oh, no.
Well, who did then?
Young man, it was we who saved you. Oh, be not afraid. Why, and I so might too. Here our great queen sends you this portrait. It is a likeness of her daughter. If so, she said, these features prove not indifferent to you, then happiness, honor, and fame lie in wait for you.
Evil fiend!
Abducted? Oh, ye gods! Tell me, maidens, how could this have happened?
One lovely day in May, she was sitting quite alone in the delightful cypress grove, which had always been her favorite retreat. The evil spirit crept up behind her, unobserved.
Despite her, and...
Besides having an evil heart, has the power of assuming every unimaginable shape. And in that way, he approached Femina.
That is the name of the princess whom you so admire.
Femina, torn away from me, in the hands of a lustful fiend. Perhaps, at this very moment, you are... Ah, dreadful thought!
No more, youth.
Do not impugn the virtue of that pure-hearted beauty. Despite all of her suffering, her innocence prevails and she remains true to herself. Neither force nor flattery can lead her astray down paths of vice.
Tell me, maidens, tell me where this tyrant dwells.
He lives beyond our mountains, past the sunflowers and near the giant shoe. This land is magnificent, but vigilantly guarded.
Come, set me on my way. Femina shall be rescued. The fiend falls by my hand. I swear it by my love, by my heart!
Thank you.
not I. Yourselves have made it plain that is like a savage beast. Is the nostril's conscience catching you and having but a nose and a nose and a nose him? Or he beat me to his dogs?
The joy of the prince and have no fear, no mercy when he is near.
Or may the devil take the stranger. I have no wish to die, and at the slightest sight of danger, I am sure he will fly.
I can't stand it.
come for me.
He's come for me.
Shoo, 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 shoo.
Thank you. For thy notes could charm.
Romeo's pipe.
Perhaps Romeo has been wrong. Perhaps Romeo's at a sign. Perhaps, perhaps, the flute will be my rhyme. So now I'll wait inside with the magic flute, a waiting sign.
Thank you.
then be tried. So place a veil upon their heads, for first they must
reason that I removed her from her arrogant mother. That woman thinks herself so great. She hopes by glamour and superstition to delude the people and destroy our firmly founded temple, but she shall not succeed. Tamino, that noble youth himself, will join us in fortifying our temple, and as an initiate, he will be the recompense of virtue and the scourge of wickedness.
Great Sarasa, we mock and marvel at your words of wisdom. But will Tamino be able to withstand the severe trials that await him within? Forgive me for so freely leaving my youth. But I fear for this youth. What if, sunk in sorrow, his spirit failed him, and he succumbed in the art of the strife? He is a prince.
Nay, more, he is a man.
And what if, still in the flower of his youth, he should fade and die?
Then he will be given over to the holiest of mysteries, and will know the joys of the gods sooner than me. And you, friend, whom the gods, through us, have appointed the spokesman of truth, you will bring them to us.
where are we now? Well, if it wasn't so dark, I might be able to tell you. But as it is now...
Oh, dear! What's wrong now?
This sort of thing doesn't really agree with me.
You're afraid by the sound of your voice.
Not afraid. It's just that icicle shivers keep running up and down my spine.
Oh, dear! What's wrong now?
Oh, my, the fever.
Shame, Volcano. Be a man.
I wish I was a girl.
Yes, young prince, there's still time to draw one step further, and it would be too late.
May the attainment of wisdom be my goal, and Kamina, the fair maiden, my reward.
You submit to every trial, then?
To every trial.
Your hand on it. Very well.
Before you go on anymore, allow me to say a word to this stranger. Don't you also want to strive for the love of wisdom?
But striving isn't really my thing. And... to be honest, I don't really care much for wisdom. I'm just a child of nature. Eating something in nature is more than enough for me. And if possible, I catch myself a pretty little wife.
You'll never manage that unless you undergo our trials.
Well, what exactly do your trials consist of?
To submit to all our rules and to not shrink, even in the face of death.
I'll stay single.
You could attain a virtuous, beautiful wife.
I'll stay single.
Sebastian had set aside for you a young lady, just like you, plumage and coloring.
Just like me?
Just like you.
Is she young?
Young and pretty.
Oh, what's her name?
Papagena.
What? Papagena!
Papagena!
Oh, I'd love to see her, just out of curiosity.
See who you may, but until the
end. Oh, but once I've seen her, then do I have to die? Oh, yes.
Your hand on it. You shall see her.
On you too, Prince. The gods impose a salutary silence. Without it, both of you are lost. You will see Paulina, but you may not speak to her. This is the first stage of your trials.
Command. You must have heard of their saying, "On the men who gather here."
A wise man walks in wisdom's way.
will need this for the trials ahead. So now, with pure hearts, let us continue on our journey.
Initiates, and Zoroastra will avoid as madly as I.
making me tremble. Is it the murder you're planning?
So you know?
Everything. What's more is I also know that not only Lorelai, but your mother's two lives in my hands.
No.
I know. Just one word to arrest her and your mother will be destroyed.
No.
So there's really only one way you can save both you and your mother.
And what's that?
Love me.
Oh, God!
Hey! Now, young lady, yes or no?
No.
And why? Because I'm not your precious domino. Then die!
No, please! See me on my knees before you spare me, Rascatos!
Okay. Then love or death. Speak. Your life is in the balance.
My heart is devoted to the young man.
I don't care about your devotion, so speak!
No!
Then die!
Enough, Tedros!
Lord, my undertaking should not be punished. They swore your death. I just wanted to avenge you.
I know all too much. I know that your soul is black, and I would punish your undertaking with the utmost severity, and not the dagger for your deed been forged by a wicked woman, who nevertheless has a most virtuous daughter.
Okay, I'll look for the mother since the daughter's plainly not meant for me. Forgive me, Lord.
Go, deal with you later.
Sebastian, please, spare my mother. Her anger is over my absence.
I know all. I know that she prowls the grounds of the temple, plotting revenge upon me and upon humanity. But you will see how I take revenge upon your mother. May the gods grant the noble youth courage and determination on his bold endeavor. Then you will find happiness with him. Let us venture onward. Their trials are not yet complete. I will take you to him, where you yourself will be challenged.
Tell us anything else.
must be some love affair. And tell me, what's the name of this boyfriend of yours?
Papageno!
And where might he be, this Papageno?
What?
prince. Your conduct has so far been manly and resolute. If your heart still beats for Flamina with the same ardor, and if you wish to reign as a wise ruler, then may the gods accompany you further.
Can we not speak?
He awaits you to say a final farewell.
A final farewell? Where is he going?
Another challenge. He must pass through the final gate.
No, Flamina, please.
Stand back!
Shall we never meet again?
Yes, enjoy you meet again.
But your path is marked by killing angels.
The gods will protect and guide the stranger. Must go.
If you loved me with all of your devotion, my words would melt your heart.
My love, I share your emotions. My whole heart is yours alone. But I must go.
The hour strikes. We must get started.
Drink water? No! In that case...
promise I will always be faithful to you until I find someone prettier.